Good morning, all the students. I welcome all of you for the first lecture of the subject Kinematics of Machinery. Previously, this subject was named as Theory of Machines 1 and Theory of Machines 2, but according to our syllabus, the structure and curriculum of the Pune University, now the name of the subject is Kinematics of Machinery. So, let us see. Means first, theory of machine is actually given two parts, that is kinematics and kinetics. So according to our syllabus, we are going to learn only the kinematics. So theory of machine means what? It is an applied science which is used to understand the relationship between the motion and geometry of the parts and the forces which are responsible for that motion. Okay. So kinematics means what? It deals with the relative motion between the various parts. It is concerned with the motion. And here we don't consider any mass and force. It is related to displacement, velocity and acceleration. So according to our syllabus, we are going to study only kinematics. Okay. And kinetics means it deals with the inertia forces, which is the combined effect of mass and motion of the parts. So first, let us see kinematic link. Because here we are going to study machine and mechanism. Okay, kinematic link means what? It is a part of the machine. It is a single part of that machine or body. Now, there are different types of bodies. Rigid body means what? It is a body which does not undergo any deformation under the action of external forces. Okay, means there is no change in the shape of body, or there is no change in its physical form. Second type of body is elastic body or flexible. It is a body which undergoes slightly deformation under the action of external forces but regain its original shape. Okay, for example, spring, if you apply the spring, it is compressed or expand, again that spring regain its original shape. But the resistant body, it is a body which is capable of transmitting motion and forces. Okay. So, kinematic link, it is a resistant body. Maybe it is a rigid body, maybe it is elastic body, but it should be capable of transmitting motion and forces. Okay. Each part of a machine which more related to the other, that is also called as kinematic link. A link may be consist of several parts which are rigidly attached together, then there is no relative motion between them. Okay. So, kinematic link also defined as a member or combination of members connecting other members having motion relative to them. So, kinematic link must be a resistant body. Means it should be capable of transmitting motion and form, whether it is rigid or elastic. So I will give the example of reciprocating engine mechanism, that is kinematic link. Now here we consider the frame or that cylinder, link number 1, which is a kinematic link. Link number 2, crank, that is a kinematic link. Link number 3, it consists of small end bearing, big end bearings. Small end bearings, big end bearings and connecting rod which forms one kinematic link. Piston rod, cross head, which constitute one kinematic link. Okay, so here this particular figure shows the different kinematic links. Okay, and here there is relative motion between the crank and frame. Okay, cylinder and piston, connecting rod and piston, connecting rod and crank. Here we can see animated figure. Here that is a complete motion of that is piston inside cylinder, connecting rod, the movement of crank. Okay, so here this figure shows the different kinematic links. Okay, so now here we understood what is mean by kinematic link. Now what are the different types of link? Rigid link, flexible link and fluid link. Rigid link means what? It is the link which does not undergo any deformation while transmitting motion. Flexible link means what? It is deform, partly deform while transmitting motion, but again regain its original shape. Okay, fluid link means what? The motion is transmitted with the help of fluid pressure. When we consider the rigid link, so here we can say connecting rod, it is a rigid link. When you apply any external force on the connecting rod, there is no change in its physical form, but still it transmits the motion. Then when we consider a flexible link, spring, it is a flexible link. It is partly deformed, again regain its original shape, but it transmits motion. And the example of fluid link is that is a hydraulic brakes. These are the, this is the example of fluid link, because with the help of the fluid pressure of the fluid, we can apply the force, that is the braking force. Now the constrained motion. Constraint means what? That is the restriction on the relative motion of the parts. Okay, so there are three types of constrained motion. First one is completely constrained motion, second one is incomplete constrained motion, and third one is successfully constrained motion. So completely constrained motion means what? If the constrained motion is achieved by the pairing element themselves, it is called a completely constrained motion. Means what happens here? Here there are two elements. One, there is a rectangular rod, okay, and rectangular hole, two elements. So here there is a rectangular rod which is having only one motion in particular definite direction, that is sliding motion, okay, and there is no need to apply any external force or to use any third motion element to achieve this particular motion. These two links which is achieved by themselves this particular motion. So here one of the link which is having a motion in particular definite direction with respect to other link, so that is called as completely constrained motion. Incomplete constrained motion means what? When the motion between the two links is more than one direction, means one of the link which is having a motion, it is suppose rotary or it is suppose sliding more than one direction in x and y and z axis, then it is called as incomplete constrained motion. What happened in this case, in this figure? Shaft which is having rotary motion inside that bearing hole, but the shaft having also sliding motion. So there are two motions in two directions. So it is called as incomplete constrained motion. Okay. Now the last one is a successfully constrained motion. When incomplete constrained motion is converted into that complete constrained motion, that is called as successfully constrained motion. So when the motion between the link is not completely constrained by itself, but it is made by some other means, means where you use some external force or where to use some third motion element to achieve that completely constrained motion, that is called as successfully constrained motion. You can see the example. Now here we can see this is a shaft and bearing, that is the previous example. So here we have to provide the keyway inside that bearing and key seat inside the shaft. Then we have to place the key in that keyway, so that key which prevents the sliding motion of the shaft. So in this way we can achieve the completely constrained motion. Now the shaft can having only one motion, that is a rotary motion. So this is called as successfully constrained motion. Here we can see the photograph of that shaft and bearing and the key. Okay. So next time we will see the kinematic pairs in the next lecture. So thank you. Thank you very much.